We now have flanges. Flangeless. Welcome back to Johnny's XJ. One down, three to go. Three down, one to go. But I would say, if you are doing this and it's an XJ900 diversion, yes, I think it's quite common with the diversion 900, these rubbers fail. And these are very expensive, as you know. So if this trick works, then yes, that's all good, copy it. But if it doesn't, don't copy it. But I would like to say that always make sure you number 1, 2, 3, 4. Because they are all different shapes. And if you try to put them on the wrong way around, you will be in trouble when you try to put your carburetors on. So make sure you mark them before you take them off. No good, is it? Too loose, man. Too fucking loose. Yes, they were a bit too big, so we've got more rubber tube. So I want to measure the halfway point of these and cut them in half. They're about 3 inches, so what's that? 1.5 inches. Turn it round just to make sure. Perfect. Now, how are we going to cut them? They're not quite as firm as these ones, which are too big. So, I don't know. Let's try the junior axle. So we've measured the mark. Now we want a nice straight line all the way round, and I'm sure we all know how to do that with a piece of paper. And that should be nice and straight. Then we can cut it off. Cut it off, can't we? Cut it off with the cutter. So I've just found an old tube socket. Then I can stick that in there. Can you see? then I can put it in the vise, and then I can stop it from squashing. Hopefully, and just joe round it. Got a newer blade axle, a better axle with a newer blade. Oh yeah, that's better. It's a lot better. Just goes to show that nice looking tools are never as good as horrible looking tools. And that is very furry. So that's one. Trying to follow the moulding, isn't it? Use the scissors. That'll do. Perfect. Try and get them on the carburetors. And they are a bit of a tight fit, so use a bit of lubricant. And hopefully we can get them on. Look at that. Way too small. Well, well, well. Let's try another angle. Oh, so that's one on, and that should go in there. And hopefully that's going to work. Okay, so we remove the straps by drilling the bolts out. They're all snapped, obviously. So I still want to try and salvage them. Bought some new Jubilee clips for the other end. You know, what goes onto the flange. I want to save these to put back on the carburetors. So I have to get the broken bolts out and then source some new bolts. Source some new bolts. So let's try and get them out. The old mole grips. Oh, yep, it's turning. One down, three to go. All I need now is some new bolts. Okay, so now I find four long bolty screws that fit my clamps. Perfect size. So now we're cooking on gas. Just cut the screw off to size and perfect. Sod's law, innit, after saying all that. Look how thick they are to that. Yeah, they're not even going to fit. What a waste of time. Still, we can find another way. Thank God for Jubilee clips. Ta-da! Yep, typical, isn't it? Got to the last bolt and the Allen key is spinning round inside the hole. That one's come undone. But the last one. No, I'm not going to do it for you. So it's either an hammer and chisel, or I'm thinking of welding my key in there. Stick it in there somewhere and try and weld it. I know I'll only get to about there, but I don't care as long as it happens. I'll just cut that off with a grinder. I don't know, let me think about it. They've decided I'm going to try and chisel it undone. Try a bigger hammer. I think it's going. Just can't get the bloody angle on it. Right, I think we can see that better. Pretty sure it's moved, but can't get the bloody chisel on it now. Because the bloody camera's in the bloody way, isn't it? definitely loose on it. Let's try one of these Storkies. Do they fit? Oh yeah, baby. Yeah. Yeah. Oh my God. This is a fantastic moment in history. Too much damage, did I? Not worried about that, I've got plenty of those bolts. So there we have it. Easy peasy. Lemon squeezy. Is off at last. Just got to take that pipe off. Four down, none to go. Put a bit of sealant on them to make sure. Now this stuff, you don't just stick it straight on, you leave it for a while for the thinners to evaporate. So just let them stand for 10 minutes or whatever, but do both sides. Both sides of the job. Only need a thin layer. Thank you. forget to put the bracket back on. Need to tighten them too tight. And these aren't upside down. And then the last two. Well, so I guess that's it. Time to wrap up this video. I've had enough. Don't forget to hit the like button, leave comments, share, or even subscribe to my channel. It will be much appreciated. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoy it. See you again soon. Bye.